Hi children, you are warmly welcome to my channel. Today we are going to start a new lesson series, Complex Numbers for Beginners. If you like my channel and want to see more videos, please subscribe and click on bell icon. Before we start up learning complex numbers, we need to see whether what is a complex number. From a simple example, if you get square root of plus 4, we know that you can write the answer plus 2 or minus 2, where 2 is a real number. Then, if you get plus 2 squared, you obtain plus 4. With the meantime, if you get minus 2 squared even, you get plus 4. Therefore, we can confirm that square root of plus 4 is plus 2 or minus 2. But if you want to find the square root of minus 4, we cannot say it's either plus 2 or minus 2. The reason is that if you square plus 2, you get the answer plus 4, not minus 4. If you get square minus 2, you get plus 4, it's not minus 4. Therefore, you cannot say square root of minus 4 from this normal number patterns. To describe the square root of minus numbers, we define a new number type called complex numbers. The definition of a complex number I is square root of minus 1. We define square root of minus 1 as I. With this fact, we can define the square roots of a negative number. In next videos, we will be learning how to operate these complex numbers. When we discuss about complex numbers having two components. Usual format of a complex number you can write as z is equals to a plus bi. Usual notation for a complex number is z. Therefore, you can write a complex number by z equals to a plus bi. The first component is called the real component. That contains only real numbers just like 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. The other component is called the complex component. That is in terms of I. Therefore, you can write it as 2i, 3i, minus 4i, etc. If you get these examples in 2 plus 3i, we call 2 as the real component and 3 as the complex component, or we can call 3i as the complex component. If you get example 2 in 4 minus 3i, 4 is called the real component and minus 3 or minus 3i is called the complex component. In 3, there is no I component. Therefore, you can write 3 is the real component and 0 or 0i is the complex component. From this example, you can get a slight idea that any real number 3 or any of the real number is a some kind of a complex number with 0 complex component. Let's try to learn about certain operations between complex numbers. First operation is to add two complex numbers. If you get first complex number z1 as a1 plus b1 I and second complex number is a2 plus b2 I, if you add z1 plus z2, you can get the that is the addition of a1 plus b1 I plus a2 plus b2 I. In such addition, you can add these real components separately. That means a1 plus a2 separately, and you can add these complex components separately, b1 plus b2 I separately. Therefore, your final answer turn up into a1 plus a2 plus b1 plus b2 I. So when you simplify, you can get much clearer answer. From this example 1, we need to add 2 plus 3i to 4 plus 6i. Then you can add these complex components. 2 plus 4 is 6. Then 3i plus 6i, that is turn up to 9i. Then the final answer turn up into 6 plus 9i. If you move up to example 2, we have to add 3 minus 6i plus 4 plus 2i. The complex components are minus 6 and 2. The real components are 3 and 4. Therefore, you can add real components 3 plus 4 and complex components minus 6 plus 2. So your answer turn up into 3 plus 4, 7. Minus 6 plus 2i is minus 4i. If you come up with example 3, that is 4 plus 6 plus 3i. I told you that any real numbers also a part of a complex number. Therefore, if you add the real components, that is 4 plus 6. Then if you get the complex components, from the first number, the complex component is 0. And for the second number, the complex component is 3i. Therefore, you can add 3 plus 0i. Your final answer turn up into 10 plus 3i. The next operation is subtraction or difference between two complex numbers. Then, if you subtract two complex numbers Z1, A1 plus B1 I and Z1 equals to A2 plus B2 I. As same way what you operate from the addition of complex numbers, we can subtract the real components separately and complex components separately. Therefore, your answer turn up into A1 minus A2 plus B1 minus B2 I. For example, if you want to subtract 4 plus 6i out of 2 plus 3i, you can subtract 2 minus 4, the real components, 3i minus 6i, the complex components, and your answer turn up into 2 minus 3i. In example 2, 3 minus 6i minus 4 plus 2i, real components, 3 minus 4, complex components, minus 6 minus 2i. Your final answer is minus 1 minus 8i. Example 3. 4 minus 6 plus 3i. Real components 4 minus 6. Complex components. For the first number, the complex component is 0. Therefore, you can write 0 minus 3i. The final answer turn up into 2 minus 3i. Powers of a complex number is the next operation. If you get I to the power 0, we know that any term, any variable, any digit, any factor to the power 0 is 1. Therefore, this is common for these complex numbers as well. I to the power 0 is 1. If you get I to the power 1, that is I. That is a simple algebraic operation. If you get I squared, this is the important point. We know that we can write I squared as I into I. Therefore, we know that definition of I is square root of minus 1. Then when you multiply square root of minus 1 into square root of minus 1, answer is minus 1. Remember that when you squared it, only the square root get vanished. Not the minus 1 into minus 1 turn up to plus 1. It would be obviously minus 1. So, I squared value is minus 1. Then if you get I cube, I can write I cube as I squared into I. We know that I squared value is minus 1. Therefore, you can write minus 1 into I is minus I. If you want to get I to the power 4, you can write that is I squared into I squared, where I squared is minus 1. Therefore, it turn up into minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. If you want to get I to the power 5, you can write I to the power 4 into I. I to the power 4 is 1, 1 into I is I. Now, if you write this tentatively, you can understand that a sequence generate. What the sequence? 1, I, minus 1, minus I. Again, start with 1, I, minus 1, minus I, continuous as it is. Hopefully you can understand the sequence. We have learned about powers of I prior to products of complex numbers, because to operate a complex number we should know about certain powers of I. Let's try to understand the product of complex numbers. If you get two complex numbers Z1, A1 plus B1i, and Z2, A2 plus B2i, and if you multiply Z1 plus Z2, that would be the answer for A1 plus B1i into A2 plus B2i. Use the usual way of removing brackets. As you same way what you did in removing brackets, do this expansion. That means first term to first term, first term to second term, then second term to first term, and second term to second term. Usual way what you did in the removing brackets. If you do so, you'll be getting the answer A1 A2 plus A1 B2i plus B1A2i plus B1B2i squared. If you simplify this, you can understand that B1B2i squared, I squared is minus 1, we know from the previous theory. Therefore, you can understand that A1A2 and B1B2 become real numbers. Then you can add them together and you can write it as A1A2 minus B1B2. And you can understand that A1B2 and A2B1 should be complex components. Therefore, you can write A1B2 plus A2B1i as the complex component. Your final answer would be A1A2 minus B1B2 plus A1B2 plus A2B1i. Hopefully, you can understand how to multiply two complex numbers. We will verify this from examples. Let's start with first example. If you get two complex numbers Z1, 2 plus 3i and Z2, 5 plus 7i. If you multiply them together, that is turn up into 2 plus 3i into 5 plus 7i. Then if you multiply them, you can get 2 into 5 plus 2 into 7i, 3i into 5 plus 3i into 7i. With that, if you operate, you can get the answer 10 plus 14i plus 15i plus 21i squared, where I squared is minus 1. Therefore, the real component would be 10 minus 21 is minus 11. Complex component is 14 plus 15i, that is 29i. If you move back to second example, the other first complex number is 2 minus 4i and second complex number is 3 plus 7i. If you multiply them together, you can use the same operations and you can obtain the final answer 38 plus 2i. Please work out and see whether can you get the same answer. The next theory we need to learn about, and a very important theory in complex number, is complex conjugate. Usually, we denote the complex conjugate of a complex number Z as Z star or Z bar. These are the usual notations we use to represent the conjugate of a complex number Z. Then what is this conjugate operation stands for? If you get any complex number Z is A plus BI, you can write its conjugate as A minus BI. That means it's a negative operation of the complex component. Then if you get the complex number as A minus BI, the conjugate is A plus BI. Simply, you can understand if you get any complex number 2 plus 3i, its conjugate would be 2 minus 3i. If you get 4 minus 5i, you get conjugate as 4 plus 5i. Only the operation is you have to change the sign of the complex component. Hopefully you can understand this. Then we have to learn about what happens if you operate certain operations with complex number and its conjugate. See whether if you add two complex numbers, what do you get? A plus BI plus its conjugate is A minus BI. If you operate them together, A plus A turn up to 2AN, bi minus bi get cancels and turn up into 2a. And what you can understand is complex component get disappear. That's what you need to understand. Then if you subtract z minus z bar, if you subtract its conjugate from a complex number, that is a plus bi minus a minus bi. Therefore, a minus a get cancels and bi minus bbi turn up into 2bi. You can understand that real component get disappear. The next operation is if you multiply any complex number by its conjugate. So a plus bi multiply with a minus bi. It doesn't matter if you start with a minus bi multiply. If it is so, you have to multiply with a plus bi. If you operate this, you can understand that it's the same way. Just like multiplying brackets. A into a into minus bi, bi into a, and bi into bi. With that, you can understand that abi cancels with minus abi. Therefore, the complex component get cancelled off. And I squared is minus 1. Therefore, the final answer turn up into a squared minus b squared. Then you can understand that if you multiply a complex number from its conjugate, your answer is a squared minus b squared. That is the square of the component of the real part minus the square of the component of the complex part. That is why you need to understand by multiplying complex number with its conjugate. We have learned the complex conjugate because it's supportive to operate the operation division of complex numbers. Suppose that you get two complex numbers z1, a1 plus bi, have to divide by a2 plus b2i. To operate this division of complex numbers, what you need to do is you have to multiply this fraction, the denominator and the numerator, both by conjugate of the denominator. That means you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by a2 minus b2i divided by a2 minus b2i. Then expand the brackets as usual. What you did, you can get the final answer for division of complex numbers. Let's try to work out this division to verify our theory. Let z1 is equals to 2 plus 3i and z2 is 7 plus 4i. We need to find the value for z1 divided by z2. That means 2 plus 3i should be divided by 7 plus 4i. That means 2 plus 3i divided by 7 plus 4i should multiply with the conjugate of the denominator. That is conjugate of 7 plus 4i. You have to multiply with 7 minus 4i, numerator and denominator. If you expand the numerator separately, you will receive the answer 26 plus 39. You operate from the previous theorems what you have learned about complex multiplication and you will obtain this answer. If you divide the denominator, that will be turned up into 65. You can operate the previous slide theory. We know that if you multiply any complex number with its conjugate, that is the square of the real component minus square of the complex component. With that, you can get that answer itself. Nothing to worry. You just work out and see whether can you obtain this answer. Then, your final answer would be 26 divided by 65 plus 39 divided by 65. Let's try to verify from the second example as well. Z1 is 2 plus 4i, Z2 is 7 minus 4i. Then if you want to divide Z1 plus Z1 divided by Z2, answer the operation would be 2 plus 4i divided by 7 minus 4i. Therefore, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by conjugate of 7 minus 4i, which is 7 plus 4i. If you multiply and if you simplify, you will receive the answer minus 2 over 65 plus 36i over 65. Nothing to worry. You just expand the brackets and see whether can you obtain this answer. Hope you have gained a good knowledge about basics of complex numbers and hope to bring you more videos in this video series about complex numbers and many more videos in my channel. If you like this video, please put a big thumbs up and please subscribe my channel and put the click on the bell icon, and you will obtain the newly added video from my channel. Thank you. See you again.